needs. That year, he went to the United Nations in New York and received to accept the Franklin Delano Roosevelt International Disability Award on behalf of Canada. And then with Prime Minister Chrétien, the government of Canada received this prestigious recognition, and NEEDS was a non-governmental organization to receive the grant portion of the award for his good work. Please join me in welcoming Honorable Kent Hare.
Taylor, for that very kind introduction. And before I get started, I'd just like to note that trip down memory lane. What an amazing time it was, and to recognize the National Education Association of Disabled Students for not only the work they did back then, the work they're doing today. And I can say, without my involvement with that organization, without the encouragement of people like Frank Smith, the executive director, and all those people who served with me, who knows if I would be here today. And I can tell you, they really sparked that fire for being involved in their community, for putting your shoulders to the wheel like so many of us in this room, and trying to get there. But here today is extraordinary. I'm here with many of my fellow parliamentarians from all sides of the aisle, and I know that they're all so supportive and proud of the things that we have accomplished together and what we will continue to do. Thank you so much for coming out and supporting this very, very important event. I think it's important that we acknowledge that we're gathered here today on the territory of the Algonquin people, who have been building community here for generation upon generation upon generation, and who I am proud, and I know we all are proud, to share the land and build community with them here today. And it's a great opportunity for us to celebrate on International Day of Persons with Disabilities, and to be here with all of you who have come from far and wide, from coast to coast to coast, who have put your shoulder to the wheel and helped build communities. So we understand how disability impacts individuals, families, communities across this nation. And we know that it isn't always easy. And yet, people in this room get up, go help, build that sense of camaraderie, that sense of purpose, that sense that people with disabilities and exceptionalities have a tremendous amount to give each and every day to this great country. And in fact, we do that each day. And now you should be applauded and commended for that work. Well, today marks the 25th anniversary of this day that was started by the United Nations, in 1992. I think some progress has been made. May we also understand that things here in Canada are not where we all want it to be. In fact, the statistics out there are still very difficult with people with disabilities. You're more likely to be out of work. You're more likely to live in poverty. You're more likely to have a difficulty finding housing. You're more likely not to have the support you need in your community to live and achieve what you want out of life. And I can say, our government, in fact, people like me who got involved in this business for the reasons that of making this country better. And, you know, it depends on what you believe in and how the government plays a role in that. But it's essentially fine that most of the people who are involved with me, and in fact, the Prime Minister, he bases things on a couple of things. And he says, he wants to say, look at policies and say, if you're born of a rich family or one that struggles, you get an opportunity to build your life. There's ways government can do that to ensure that happens. I think he also looks at this, and I know our party is looking at this, like, It shouldn't matter whether you're born with a disability, whether you acquire a disability, or whether you're able-bodied. You should have an opportunity to live a great Canadian life. And we believe for that fundamentally to happen, there has to be a role for government in this. Your government has to be there, putting the shoulder to the wheel with each and every one of you in this room. And I believe that we are taking real, tangible steps to seeing the lives of people with disabilities improve in this country and have better outcomes, right? Just want to name a few. You might have heard. We came out with the National Housing Strategy this week. Did anyone see that?
Yes, I did.
For the first time in 25 years, the federal government has been involved in housing. We're getting there in a big way. And we know people with disabilities suffer housing shortages at greater rates than the average citizen. In fact, in Calgary, there's only 400 rental units that are fully accessible in that city. The city of 1.3 million people. We know we have people with disabilities languishing in hospitals because they can't get out to find spaces in their communities to live. People with intellectual disabilities who do not have the ability to build their lives. In that release of that policy, we announced there were 500,000 new builds that we are going to be doing. 20% of them are dedicated to fully accessible places. We also know that people with intellectual disabilities are also wanting that opportunity to live a great Canadian life, and you can do that when you have a home. We've recognized that. With a cargo there as well, with wraparound supports that's going to be able to see housing as a human rights approach.
Yeah.
I think this is important. Our government's also recognize this where there are investments in infrastructure, where we're going to be building LRTs, bus systems, and different infrastructure around this country. It is going to be built with a disability lens around to ensure you're accommodating to make sure that we're able to use And then, well, as politicians, we like talking about ourselves. So we got around to little old me. I'm your Minister of Sport and Persons with Disabilities. So before I go first, I'm also joined here by my Parliamentary Secretary, Stephane Lazone, who's working for me so hard. Board, thank you for your leadership, Stephane. It's very, very important the work you do. We wouldn't be able to do it without you. But it gets back to sort of what we're doing, okay? And the Prime Minister has said to us, you're going to be bringing in first-time legislation that ensures federally regulated industries are done with purpose around support and understanding of what it's like to be have a disability and not be served by your government. Instead of us have to be a reactionary system where we have to keep banging down the door, we're going to get things right the first time. This is in the built environment. This is in service delivery to ensure you get the service you need and the language and different supports you need. The way we're going to do procurement and the way we're going to provide opportunities for people to get employment. This is a big deal we're going to be coming out with here in the spring. And I know Is former Minister Carla Qualtro here today? Okay, no she isn't, but I know she worked with you in the consultation process to hear your ideas, to bring what you want, that you want the opportunity to build your lives. Okay. Our government understands that. Okay, so I believe that you have a true partner in this Prime Minister and a true partner in our government. Today. I don't know if anyone was paying attention.
Yeah.
And in 2010, we signed on to the Rights of the Disabled Person of the United Nations. Okay?
Yes.
And many in this room have been saying, government, when you get off your duff and sign the optional program. Is that true?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, today we took the next step in going down that path. We tabled the legislation, the House of Commons. board this day. We'll continue to work with the rest of the province. We're going to use a football analogy here, and we're going to get this through the goalposts. We're going to make sure we do. But I think it's important, though, that our government could not have done it with many people without the help of people in this room. Who I've known for a long, long time, who built this country, who've led by example, who have done those great things in our community to really ensure that we're in a place where your government understands this as now working with you. Okay. I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for the work you do each and every day, for being here tonight to celebrate our successes and to continue to go boldly forward, to continue to work for this truly noble endeavor to get people with unique challenges an opportunity to live a great community life. Thank you so much.